Hey, Weasel, you could have hurt my cat, man. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the BJ Rubin Show.
BJ Rubin's got a show tonight. He's in the know tonight. He's gonna go tonight. When he's rubbing you the wrong way, then you know that he's right. BJ Rubin's got a show tonight.
But seriously, folks, it's the American Liberty League.
Put another nickel in the nickel in. Closer, my dear, come closer. The part is part of it. When you dance it close to me, put a nickel in the Nickelodeon. The sweetest part of it, you follow me when you're dancing close to me. Put another nickel in the Nickelodeon. All I want is having you and music, music. All I want is having you and music, music, music.
Catch an ocean liner to be with Donnelly. BJ's gonna make you a stud.
Simon came to school one morning. His mother brought him in her immense station wagon. When the immense station wagon stopped, we all yelled, "Good morning, Simon," but Simon was having a bad morning. Simon's mother opened the back door of the immense station wagon so Simon could come out, but Simon didn't want to come out. Our friend Simon didn't want to go to school that day. Simon's mother said to Simon, "Come out, Simon," but Simon would have none of that. Simon's mother reached in and took Simon by the hand, but Simon planted one foot on the back of the front seat. Simon propped another foot on the front of the back seat. Simon seized an armrest with one hand. Simon grabbed a headrest with another hand. Our friend Simon wedged himself into the back seat of Simon's mother's immense station wagon. We yelled, we shouted, we hollered, we howled, "Come out, Simon, it's time to go to school," but Simon would have none of that. He rammed his head against the back of the front seat. He jammed both feet against the front of the back seat. He hugged the headrest of the front seat with both hands. He bit into the armrest and held onto it with his teeth. Our friend Simon had wedged himself into the back seat of his mother's immense station wagon and would not come out and go to school. Our friend Simon's best friend, Timmy Timmons, tried to talk to Simon. "Come out, Simon, it's time to go to school." But Simon would have none of that. Our friend Simon threw himself onto the floor of his mother's immense station wagon. He clasped the underside of the front seat with one hand. He grasped the seatbelt of the back seat with another hand. He situated one foot on the front bottom of the back seat. He lodged another foot under the rear bottom of the front seat. Our friend Simon kept on wedging himself into the back seat of his mother's immense station wagon. But Timmy Timmons thought to try a tonic. He rushed away to Lunchman Claude. Timmy Timmons questioned Claude. "Lunchman Claude, what is the soup du jour?" "Why, Timmy Timmons, today is Tuesday. Of course, the soup du jour is French onion soup." "Why, French onion soup served with a spoon is our friend Simon's soup of choice. May I have a serving to save our school?" "For Simon's sake, certainly," said Lunchman Claude. He ladled out a lordly serving of French onion soup and lobbed it at Timmy Timmons along with the spoon. Timmy Timmons was back in a flash with French onion soup for our friend Simon. Simon pulled one hand from the underside of the front seat. Simon let go of the seatbelt of the back seat with another hand. Simon took one foot off the front bottom back of the back seat. Simon disentangled another foot from under the rear bottom of the front seat. Simon sprang from the back seat of the immense station wagon and seized the soup and spoon from Timmy Timmons. Savoring the soup and seeming insatiable, Simon slurped and sipped and smacked and swallowed until the whole bowl of French onion soup was gobbled up. "School can start since Simon's here," we yelled, we shouted, we hollered, we howled. Lunchman Claude was close at hand to see that the soup got safely to Simon. Simon smiled and said some syllables. "My compliments to the chef."
This is a message from the Bureau of Public Safety. Dizziness, headache, and fatigue may be some of the early warning signs of a complex of conditions that often require early medical consultation. When neglected, symptoms may worsen. Joint pain, muscle weakness, shortness of breath, and ringing in the ears may ensue. If left untreated, there may be loss of consciousness, hallucinations, bouts of nausea, numbness in extremities, heart palpitations, and blurred vision. Tell your doctor if you experience any of these, as brain aneurysm, stroke, paralysis, heart failure, diabetic coma, seizures, or sudden death may be imminent. Thoughts of suicide, terror of death, obsession with mortality, violent fantasies, self-destructive acts, mental aberrations, morbid fixations, and disaster obsession may point to underlying or pre-existing complications. It is imperative that you do not let these indicators go unreported. Call for an appointment now before you won't be able to ever call for an appointment again. This has been a message from the Bureau of Public Safety with a safety message for the public.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the BJ Rubin Show.
He's in the know tonight. He's gonna go tonight when he's rubbing you the wrong way. Know that he's right. BJ Rubin's got a show. BJ Rubin's got a show. Rubin's got a show tonight.
But seriously, folks, sexy thoughts.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Thank you.
He's been drinking all day. Nothing funny about alcoholism. Keep it going. Second, City Lights. You want to sing City Lights? Don't. Right. But I don't know the words. And let's sing My Friend George. My Friend George.